Hi folks, Daryl Legacy here, Instructional Designer for Hack. If you give your students narrated PowerPoint slides or lectures, this video will help you create automatic captions that students will be able to use as they follow along. Here's what it will look like when we're done. So our first slide, we're going to talk about Mars. There have been quite a few different discoveries on Mars and related to Mars in the last say 20 or 25 years. Methane was discovered, and the question is whether it was created by microbes, which is one option, or whether it was a natural geologic process. Formaldehyde has also been discovered in the atmosphere, and there's a question about whether that's microbe created. One thing that we are sure of is that there certainly was liquid water at some point in the past in Mars. You might think that captions are a waste of your time, especially if you don't have any students with hearing impairments. However, many students may not disclose their disability to you, and some might not even know that they have hearing difficulties. Plus, even able-bodied students often appreciate captions on their videos. In fact, in a major recent study from Oregon State University, 88% of students found closed captions on videos to be moderately, very, or extremely helpful. And one of the top reasons was that they believed it helped with their retention of the material. This only works using the full version of PowerPoint 365 downloaded and installed on your computer, so it won't work with the web version or with PowerPoint 2019. All faculty and staff at Hack can get Office 365 Pro Plus by signing into the On the Hub portal in MyHack, and it can be installed on up to 5 different computers. Once you have PowerPoint 365 installed, open your presentation. Go to the Slideshow tab. Then click the box that says Always Use Subtitles. Click Subtitle Settings to choose your spoken language and your subtitle language. Now, when you present your presentation using a microphone, PowerPoint will automatically make live captions. However, those captions aren't saved anywhere, so we need to do one more step. Go to the Insert tab and click the Screen Recording button in the ribbon. This allows you to record something on your desktop and insert it into your presentation. However, we want to record the presentation itself, which was automatically minimized. To make it full size again, hold down the Alt key and push Tab until it highlights PowerPoint. To make this process simpler, it's best to have only PowerPoint open, which will then be the only choice when you push Alt and Tab. If you're using a Mac, it's Command and Tab. This will now maximize PowerPoint again, but the screen is still faded because it wants you to choose the area to record. Click and hold the left mouse button to draw a dotted red box around most or all of your screen. This is the area that will be recorded. Even though your presentation is likely only taking up a small part of your screen right now, you need to record everything because we're going to change to presentation mode. If you make a mistake or it's not the right size, click the Select Area button in the window at the top. This lets you redraw your recording window. Make sure your microphone is on, and then click the small red Record button in the window at the top. It will count down and then start recording. Now we need to go into presentation mode, so click the Slideshow tab in PowerPoint and choose From Beginning. If you start talking, you'll see captions start to appear on the bottom of the screen. Continue with your presentation. If you need to pause your recording, you can do that with the player window. It may disappear when you go to slideshow mode, so hover your mouse at the top of the screen to make it come back. You can use the arrow keys to easily move forward or backward to other slides. One note, if you have slide transitions, it won't record your speech until the transition finishes, so you may want to pause speaking between slides. Even better, remove the transitions entirely. Once you're finished, click the square button in the player window to stop. Go to the File tab in PowerPoint and choose Save As. Give it a name, but we want to save it as a video file so that students can see it even if they don't have PowerPoint. So click where it says PowerPoint Presentation.pptx and select MPEG 4 Video MP4 instead. It will take some time to render, so don't close PowerPoint while it's exporting the video file. You can use other programs on your computer while waiting, though. Once it's finished, you can upload the video to D2L or to YouTube and share it with your students. Now they'll have captions on the bottom. There's currently no way to edit the captions before exporting the video, unfortunately, so they won't be perfect. And students won't be able to turn the captions off. But the captions are a huge benefit to students with hearing difficulty, and many students without hearing impairments will appreciate them as well. If you have any questions, please contact me or anyone on the CDI team.